Dear students, in the last video, we had discussed about the free fall, acceleration due to gravity. Now, let us find out what is the value of acceleration due to gravity on Earth. So, acceleration due to gravity is given by G equals to capital Gm upon R square. So, if you take this R as the radius of Earth, if you are talking that the substance, the object is lying on the surface of Earth, then it will be separated from the center of the Earth by the radius. As an example, you can understand here. Suppose something is lying on the surface of Earth and this is the center of Earth. So, the distance between that object and the center of mass of Earth will be capital R. So, G, small g, will be given by Gm upon R square. In the last video, I discussed the relationship between small g and capital G, where small g is acceleration due to gravity and capital G is universal constant of gravitation. Now, capital G is universal constant of gravitation. Whose value is this? Capital R is radius of Earth. Whose value is this? Okay. And capital M is mass of Earth. Whose value is this? When you will substitute all these parameters, the values for all these parameters in this expression, what are you going to get? You are going to get the value of small g, which comes out to be 9.8 meters per second square, which is very, very near to 10. Okay, since acceleration always has the units meters per second square, so here also I am using that. So, this is the discussion about small g, okay, which is acceleration due to gravity. Now, let's discuss what is weight. Now, there are two things that you need to be very clear of. First of all, you have mass here and then you have weight here. Let me tell you, they are different stuff. Mass is different from weight. When we talk about mass of something, we know that matter means something which has mass and occupies space. Now, mass means something, amount of substance contained in the matter. That is mass. Amount of substance contained in something. But what is weight? Now, when you all, okay, the human beings, all the organisms, everything, living, non-living things, all of them are getting attracted towards the Earth. Because of Earth's gravitational force. So, weight is basically the force with which something is attracted towards Earth. Okay, with which it is stuck on the Earth's surface. As an example, if I talk about you, your weight, suppose your weight comes out to be 50 kgs, your weight is actually telling us the force with which Earth is attracting you on its surface. Every force is written as mass into acceleration. So, weight is also a force. So, that will also be mass into acceleration, but this time the acceleration is not an ordinary acceleration, rather it is an acceleration due to gravity. It's an acceleration due to gravity, mg. But every force has a unit of newtons. So, why do we measure weight in kgs? It's actually a convention which is made. Actually, weight is measured in newtons only in scientific language. Weight is always measured in newtons. It's just a convention that we have made that I am buying 2 kgs of something, 3 kgs of something, because mass aap exactly measure nahi kar sakte ho. What you measure is weight. Okay, now if something has 50 kg weight and the other 50 newtons weight and the other thing has 80 newton weight. So, that means Earth has to apply the force of 50 newtons over that thing to bind it over its surface, and talking about the other thing. So earth has to apply 80 newtons force to bind it on its surface. So that means iska mass zyada ho gaya, that's why the earth has to apply more force. So that's why weight is, you know, sometimes replaced by kgs. But in scientific language, weight is always written in newtons. Remember that. It's a layman's convention that we have made ourselves, that we measure weight in kgs. Just imagine yourself buying some vegetables from a vegetable vendor and using this, I want 5 newtons of something. So actually, to make things easier, people have started using kgs, but actually the weight is always coming out in newtons, because the weighing machine tells us how much force earth is applying to bind that thing on its surface. Okay, otherwise it will be floating in the air, it will be flying in the air, right? So this is mass and weight, and weight is given by mg. And what are its units? Since it's a force, so its units are newtons. So this is the discussion about weight. Also, one more thing I need to discuss, that since weight is a force and force is a vector quantity, it has a direction also. So weight will also be having direction, right? And next is, at the center of the earth, acceleration due to gravity is zero, because acceleration due to gravity is the acceleration with which the objects are accelerated towards the center of the earth. If something is already lying on the center of the earth, then it will experience no acceleration because it's already on the center of the earth. So small g will be equal to zero at the center of the earth. But weight, which is equal to mg, that will also come out to be zero, because taking m as it is multiplied by, in place of g, you can write zero. So weight comes out as zero. So this means if something is weighed at the center of the earth, then its weight will be zero. Weighing machine will give you the reading of zero, right? Next topic is weight of object on moon. See, if you have one object, okay, once it is measured, its weight is measured on earth, and the other time its weight is measured on moon. Let me tell you, the weight will be different. Moon has less gravity as compared to earth. Moon has less gravity as compared to earth. And how they are related, it has been experimentally found that weight of the object on earth, on moon, sorry, is equal to 1/6 of weight of object on earth. Like if something is weighing 30 kgs on earth, the same thing will weigh 5 kgs on moon, 5 newtons. Okay, so this is the way we understand the relation between weight of an object on moon and weight of an object on earth, right? So actually what happens, the acceleration due to gravity on moon is 1/6 times the acceleration due to gravity at earth. So this is the way we understand it. I'll give you one numerical to solve.